Okay, so that is a positional leadership. So what these positional leaders have is like, you know, only kind of influence they can have is based on their job or title. Okay, so using their job or title, a positional leader can influence his people. Okay, usually positional leaders, you know, they'll have only subordinates. You know, they don't have a team member. It's because, you know, these positional leaders, they tend to rely mostly on rules, regulations, policies, and their, you know, organization's chart. Okay, so that is why if you see, you know, the people who only make it to this level one of leadership, you know, mostly become bosses. Okay, they can never be good leaders. That is because they heavily rely on, you know, these kind of, you know, set rules which have been already set by some other people, and they just blindly follow these rules. Okay, for example, you know, many of you, all of you are in corporate, okay, you all would have had some bosses, okay. So, I mean, I'll tell you one example which happened with me in a past week, okay. So, after a long time, a manager had called me, okay. I did not have an interaction with him for past 2 months, okay. Suddenly, one day morning, he called me and he asked me to, you know, generate some report. He gave me some work and he asked me to generate this report in next 2 hours, okay. And I was thinking like, suddenly he called. He didn't even, I mean, ask anything or anything. This is Bharat. We have this work. You have to get it done and all. So if you see here, I mean, actually at that time I was reading this book. Okay, in this book it says that, you know, a positional leader, whenever he asks for extra time or effort, you know, you don't tend to, you know, feel like giving it. Okay, exactly that happened to me when he called me and he said like, why would I have to do it, this work? Because this is an additional work from my day-to-day activities. He asked me to do that. Anyway, since he is my positional leader, I had to do it and I've given him the work. Then again, I was thinking about, you know, one more thing. So, I mean, I had a chance to meet so many leaders, I was telling you, right? So, Bijay, he's my mentor, right? So, he mentors me in many things, okay? So, I was actually doing one work for him, okay? So, I used to cut some, you know, videos and all. So, actually, I didn't do it. But, you know, he followed up with me. The way he followed was like, he asked me, how are you doing and all. And then he just checked with me whether I was able to do it or not. Okay. Whether I'll be able to do it or not. So that difference I noticed. So then I was thinking like, so this might be the difference between a level one leader and a level five leader where, you know, I mean, he did not, you know, influence me based on his position. He just, you know, asked me and I felt like doing that work. Then what I did is like, as soon as, you know, I got time, I was able to finish that work for Vijay. So that is the difference that I have noticed. And also that this book, the chapter, the positional leadership clearly states that, you know, these are the differences between a positional leader and a pinnacle leader. Okay. Yeah. And next week I'll be covering more about, you know, what are the advantages of being a positional leader. And there are also downsides of being a positional leader. I'll cover that in my next week's topic. Thank you.
Great sharing, Bharat. Superb. So we'll move to the next speaker. Dheeraj, I think Dheeraj has raised his hand. Dheeraj, can you unmute yourself and switch on your video if your network is fine?
Yeah, guys, I'm doing it.
Yep, just a second. I'll just spotlight you.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yep, loud and clear.
Okay. Yeah, thanks for this opportunity. I thank Bharat for introducing me to this group. And the book that I've been reading for the past 1 week is Rich Dad Poor Dad. Very interesting book. And I would like to summarize things that I've taken from this particular book. So this is written by an author called Robert T. Kiyosaki. And basically, you get a definition of wealth from this book. So in this book, by the title, the author seems to talk about two different dads. One is rich and one is poor. So I'll try and explain why he makes this kind of comparison. And it's an interesting way of projecting a particular concept and giving a definition of wealth. So here, the author, as a kid, he's not from a wealthy background. And he goes to a public school where, in general, all the kids, both rich and from poor family, study there. But the kids tend to stay away from him because he was from a poor background and his parents could not afford some of the costly gifts that the kids had. So this kind of created that question in him as to why he's not able to make friends with all those kids. So he goes to his father and asks a question, stating like, how can I be rich? So his father is actually a PhD holder. So his biological father is whom he refers to as his poor dad. The reason being, although he was very well educated and he was in a good position, financially he was not able to, do very well. Although, they were just living off their means, they were not able to make any significant wealth, because of which, the author refers to him as this poor dad. So, for his question that, how to become rich, he just gives an answer stating, you just have to, stay in school, study well, get a degree, get a good employment. I mean, this is the standard answer that we get from all of our parents, right? So this is, the kind of different approach that what the rich teach their kids. So that is what the author tries to highlight here. And this is what something, we all need to learn and also, take forward to our kids as well. So here, the author has a friend called Mike. And his father is the one whom he refers to as the rich dad. Moderately wealthy at that particular point, but over a period of time, he becomes very wealthy. And how he does that, and this is how the author highlights throughout the book. Oh, is it 3 minutes?
Unfortunately.
Okay. So yeah, probably
you can wrap it up in next 15 seconds. Yeah.
Okay. So basically, he talks about assets and liabilities. Tries to explain that we need to have more assets than liabilities. So this helps us to build a passive source of income. And whenever you make your money earn through a passive source of income, so that is where you can really, get off from your lame mundane activities of daily going to work and, making your money work and eventually think of a retirement and, be rich and wealthy in life.
Awesome. Sorry. Awesome.
I'll try to wrap it up, in a faster way. Probably I went.
That's okay, Dheeraj. It's a first time. You're first time speaking, right?
Yeah, first time.
That's really awesome. You really shared really nicely. You shared the book. It is not that small book, although you shared the gist of it.
Yeah.
Cool, man. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Cool. We'll go to the next speaker, Divya. So, Divya. Divya, can you...
Hello.
Hi, Divya. Can you switch on your video if it is feasible for you?
Actually, my net is quite not good. So,
okay, today, no issues. Yeah. You can carry on like that.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, so the book that I've started reading is The Power of the Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. And the reason I chose this book was because I'm generally an overthinker. So... I'm quite interested in how thoughts play a role in each of our behavior and the way we take our life. Thoughts have a great say in it. All of us know that thing. So being an overthinker, I was a little curious to read through this book of what it says about how our subconscious mind works. So I'm just into the first chapter and it's already got quite interesting. I'll just point out a few points that had an impact on me, or I would say wow points kind of that I really liked of or highlighted out of it. Firstly, since it is an introduction chapter kind of, so when the author starts it, he starts it by giving us an overview of or a glimpse of what positivity or a positive mind is. So that he explains it by saying that he gives an example of a magnetized steel. So if it is a magnetized steel, it can lift up to 12 times its weight, whereas a normal steel can lift nothing. So that's how much impact positivity can have in a mind. Like it acts as a magnet. it helps accomplish things in a far better way. So that is a glimpse of how much positivity can be helpful. So going further, he goes on to explain that it is everything is a cause and an effect. Just as we see in this world, everything, every effect is caused by a cause. In the same way, he goes on to say that our thoughts are the cause, and every condition or the external condition that is created around us is an effect of the thoughts. So what kind of thoughts are going on in the mind will have a say in the conditions that we go through. He explains that by telling that he was a former chemist, it seems. So he says that when you combine hydrogen and oxygen in the right proportion of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, you will always get water. So it's the same way, like if you want a certain external condition, there should be a proper proportion of the combination causes to happen to yield to that particular result. So this made perfect sense, since like if we expect a particular way of outcome, then obviously he also says that our mind is like a garden. So our subconscious mind, so whatever we sow into it, if we sow positivity, if we sow thoughts of happiness, or if we concentrate in that direction, only then we'll be able to move forward in that particular direction itself. So yeah, that is pretty much the summary of the things that I had read. Thank you.
Cool. Thank you, Divya. It was really good. Who invited you, Divya?
Bharat had invited me.
Okay, awesome. Cool. And what do you do?
I'm working as a QA.
Achha. You work in Bangalore as of now, or where do you work?
Bangalore itself.
Okay, perfect. Awesome. Great sharing. So we'll move to next speaker. After that, we'll come back to offline, one of the offline speaker here. So next, I think Charanjit is there. Charanjit, you can unmute yourself and you can switch on your video. I'll just spotlight you.
Hi, all. This is Charanjit. This is my second session that I have been attending. I've started reading a book named Attitude is Everything by Jeff Keller. So I will share whatever I've learned. So the chapter name is You Are a Human Magnet. So what does it mean? Means ki the life that you have right now, this is all about what you have attracted in your life by the way of your thoughts. So thoughts are really powerful thing, though we don't have a control on that, but the one thing that we can start doing it, intentionally think about the thing that you actually need in your life. Or you can do it. Suppose someone has a monetary goal. Okay. Someone wants to have a 50 lakh in his account, like by 2 years, or you can say any monetary goal. Okay. So you can start thinking in that way that you already own that money, and you will start attracting that thing into your life. So here is a catch. Just thinking about that thing will not only work, you have to work as well to achieve the same thing. Or you can do it, if you think about, okay, you want to, how would I say? If you want to achieve a specific position in a company, you want to join, there is a dream company that you want to be part of. Okay. Or you can start your actions. You can start giving the interview over there. You can start applying for the job on the job portal. Okay. This is the action. Certain kind of actions are also required from your side. And just thinking about and sending that you will get into your dream company will not work. So this is the first learning. And the second one is the dominant thoughts rule the day. So what does it mean? There are thoughts throughout the day coming in your mind. Okay. But what you have to do, you have to stick to one thought that you actually want in your life. So if you will, there are lots of thoughts that comes in human mind, but this is a practice that you can start with. Just stick to one thought throughout your day. I'll give an example over here. Suppose if you have any physical goal, okay, like you want to be a fit and you want to have a six packs, okay, or you start with it. You will hit a gym, okay, you will do some set of sets with the repetitions, okay, but if you will say you will perform only two sets with two repetitions and that is enough for you to achieve your goal, you will not able to make it. You have to give your best when you are in the gym. Okay, so this is what that you can do to achieve your goals. And another thing is that people will say that I am keeping a positive thoughts in my mind, but whether I'll be able to achieve whatever I want in my life. And there are so many things, negativity will come in your mind and there's so many adverse situations that you have to face. Okay, but the thing is, the core principle will be here that you have to implement is, though there will be difficulties, but you have to make sure as many as time as possible, you will stick to your positive thoughts. And I would say one more thing from my practical experience, this is not only about the thoughts. You should also keep avoiding the people who have negativity and who always think negative and who passes the negative thoughts in your life. That will make you feel like you don't have belief on the things that you really want in your life. So this is my learning from this chapter. Thank you so much.
Awesome, awesome, Charanjit. I think Madhvi wants to add something.
That was a great learning, Jeet. Thank you so much. And I also wanted to add that this is something similar. I was also learning from The Magic of Thinking Big. So it somehow correlates. So I thought I will share with you guys. So it is said that we are magnet and we attract what we think. So what happens is... if you can just mute him. Thank you. Yeah. So what happens is I will give you an example. So I have an exam. So what I will think is I will do well in exam, which means all the questions I would have already been prepared. So just thinking of that will not work. I will only know all the questions if I have done all the preparation. I have completed the entire book. So what will happen is I'll prepare to study for the entire book. If I have studied the entire book, then it is obvious that tomorrow when I go, I will have that confidence and a smile on my face. When I check through the questions, I know it already. So I'll be able to cover it. So there is, of course, no substitute to hard work. So of course, you have to work towards it. But it's true that with the people that you are surrounded with the energy that you are surrounded with and with the thought that goes in your mind is what you attract from this universe. Now that thought, you will have so many thoughts in your mind, but what is the more dominant thought? Sometimes what happens is your subconscious mind, now I'm covering so many speakers. So what happens is your dominant thought is, you know, that 80-20 Pareto applies there, where in your subconscious mind, without you even knowing, you would be fearing something. So if you fear about something and that is your dominant thought, then what will happen is you will be more in confident. Sometimes you will know things, but you will still make mistakes. So that is why it's very important to, because your subconscious mind that Anu had covered in one of the sessions, that you have to make your subconscious mind as your best friend. Best friend ko aap kya karte ho, apne sare baatein batate ho, aapko kya chahiye, what you want to do, how you want to be, what you want from life. So all those things you tell to your best friend, right? You are very, very honest with your best friend. So your subconscious mind is like that. So you just focus on that. Keep thinking positive and tell all the things, bigger things that you want from life to your subconscious mind. And automatically it will happen is that will be your dominant thought and you'll start attracting big things in life. So that's all I wanted to add. Thank you so much. It was a very nice learning. Thank you.
Awesome. Awesome. Thank you so much, Madhvi. Great. So we'll move to the next speaker over here. Neet.
Hello. Good evening, everybody. This is Puneet. I welcome all the new folks to our book club. I'm a mechanical engineer. So I was reading this book called How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. The first chapter, if you want honey from the beehive, just don't kick it. Yeah, when I read this chapter, you know, the first chapter, it's all about like criticism. I won't tell what the poet has to say about it. I will tell you one story. You know, if a child, you know, in a bench, there are two child sitting, and one is writing in a pencil and uska kuch galti ho gaya, to wo kya karega ki uske paas rubber nahi hai, to wo kya karega ki baju wale se dekhega, wahan se rubber utha ke he start rubbing it. Then he doesn't realize ki uska rubber kahan gaya. Then he will search here and there. Then he sees in his hand. Then he shouts like, अरे ये चोर है, ये चोर है. तो वहां पे क्लासरूम में सब लोग क्या बोलेंगे, चोर है, चोर है, चोर है. फिर then they'll go and complain to teacher. So at that point the boy doesn't have anything, you know, to defend himself or say I didn't rob or anything. Yeah, I didn't took it. It was just I wanted rubber. I don't have the rubber. Already people have told he's a robber. At that point, one thing he can do, he should wait.
Your voice is not audible. Sorry to interrupt.
I can't hear.
It was stopped from past, I think, 30 to 40 seconds before. We didn't heard a single word after that.
Yes.
Hello. Is it audible now?
Yes.
Yes, now it's fine.
Yes, it's audible.
Audible? Yes, it's audible.
Okay, I'll repeat it again.
Good, good.
Yeah, I'll repeat it again.
Speak far, speak louder.
When they started like telling, he's a robber, he's a robber. Then what the child, he doesn't have anything to prove his like innocence ki maine kuch galti nahi ki ya maine janbujh ke nahi uthaya. So at that point, he can do.
Oh my God, speak.
The one thing he can do, he has to wait for his time to prove his innocence. Another thing what he can do is take that as a negative and become a robber one day. So meanwhile, daily basis, we get criticized by someone else, or we may criticize to other people also. We might know, you might not know him. Jaane anjaane mein galti ho jaate. So after reading this chapter, I came to know that, you know, if there is a crowd or some family or jo bhi mere friends ho, if they start, you know, telling to someone ki, then mera, you know, hak banta hai ki I should first stop them and say, stop, you can't do this. Because it's like it may hurt somebody's feeling and they may go black or they may do something else to themselves also. Because everybody has a heart, right? So in this chapter, you know, the poet says the last sentence which I really liked, I think everybody should hear. God himself, sir, does not propose to judge a man until the end of his days. Why should you and I? So in the Zoom now, you will raise hands, right? Obviously, everybody will. If you want to speak, I think everybody should take a stand and stop this criticism from today itself. Thank you. That was
awesome, 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 Puneet. Great sharing. Great. So we'll move to the next speaker. So I think who is G B A B E L L? Is it Gauri? Kya?
Yeah. Hey everyone. This is Gauri. Nice meeting you all. There's so much synergy. Oh, is it audible?
Yeah, you're audible. Is it possible for you to switch on your video?
Yep.
Just a second. I'll just spotlight you. Cool. Yeah. Cool. Go ahead.
Nice meeting you all. I love the synergy here. so nice listening to all your learnings and all. So listening to the books you all read, it's like making imagination, thoughts, subconscious mind, they play really important role. So even I'm reading The Power of Subconscious Mind. Let me continue to what Divya has said earlier. So like as Divya told, like how important the thoughts are, and also the author tells about in the first two chapters, like how the successful people, they know the deep understanding between your conscious and subconscious, what to put in your conscious or what to put in your subconscious, how they can both together make you successful. And also if you take example of great people or successful people, in their interviews, they always tell like, oh, I dreamed of this day, I imagined this day. So you will think, even I imagine, even I dream, why don't I be successful or something like that? So it all depends, like how the way you think, how the way you put your thoughts and how you imagine day-to-day life. So in the second chapter, he tells all about how your mind works in your, like for your subconscious mind. So like it all, you will have so many thoughts, right? You'll have good thoughts, bad thoughts, positive, negative. Your subconscious mind will not know like way to filter it out. If you give good thoughts, it will take good. If you give bad thoughts, it will take bad. So you should make help of your conscious mind basing on the facts which you see day to day life, and you need to filter out what to put in your subconscious mind. Let me take an example. So like the author will tell the example of where in India we usually like believe astrologers a lot. They will predict our future, and we will go to them. One person, he goes to astrologer. He's in a really good state actually. So when he goes to the astrologer will say, oh, you have a bad heart. You will be dead by next moon or by next year, like that. That person, he believed him. He wrote his will. He told all his family members that I'm going to die. I'm not feeling well and all. He didn't even get a doctor's opinion and all. He just believed the person who told him. And so eventually, what time that person told you will die, he died. What can be the other way which would have happened is if he would have filtered out that, not filtered out, if he would have taken it like, okay, who is she to tell me? Why can't I change the thought in my mind? Why can't I think positive? If you put those kind of thoughts, it will be, he would have really survived. So that's what the author tells, like, change all the negativity in your mind. Like, I can't do it. I cannot drive, or I cannot get the job. I cannot get promotion. Don't put those negative thoughts at all. Put as much as positive, change the negative to positive. I can do it. I will get the job. I can drive. I can take this challenge. How much positive you put, it is the fuel to your conscious mind. It's not that putting the thoughts will do. Like eventually it will fuel you. That thought, it's like a knocking every time, like timer, how it knocks after a time. It's kind of that thing which will tell you like, okay, there is a positive thought. It will remind you, okay, no, you have a positive thought. Do this to your conscious mind. So yeah, that is for today. We'll go through deep for the next chapters later. Thank you all.
Awesome, Gauri. Thank you so much. In fact, people who don't know, Gauri is joining from the US. I think, what's the time over there, Gauri?
It's 8 a.m. right now. Now I need to rush.
It's too good. Too committed for growth. Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Great. So we'll move to Surbhi. Surbhi, you can.
Yes. Yeah. Hi, Kiran.
Possible.
I'm actually traveling, so cool. I can't talk. Yeah. So hello, everyone. Today, the book that I've chosen is Think Straight. It says, like, everybody's talking about thoughts today, so my book is also a similar kind. Change your thoughts, change your life. This book that I chose today is all about how you think straight. All the times we have like a lot of thoughts running in our minds, but we have the ability to choose one thought over the other. Basically, we can control what we think and our thought processes. All it comes down to is emphasizing on decision. That's what this book is all about. So let's start here. I'll be covering up a little couple of chapters in a brief. We have, as we all know, we have a lot of thoughts. Then how do you stop thinking about, you know, negative thoughts? We can think for hours and stay inside our heads, especially like hum jab sone ki koshish kar rahe hote hain raat mein. It is like, what if the ceiling falls? Ya fir zombies aa gaye. All bullshit, and like 95% of thoughts are random and silly and of no use.
like they have no meaning at all. We only need to be aware of our thoughts, acknowledge them, but never blame ourselves or say, ki, why am I having these thoughts? Instead, be aware of your thoughts and decide what you will ignore and what is important. Inside your control versus outside your control. There are a couple of thoughts which you can control and there are a couple which you cannot. Like ceiling is falling. This is a very useless thought and you cannot also control it. So there is a thumb rule for that. And that is only think about things you can control. Two main types of useful things or constructive thoughts are thinking about how you can solve problems and understanding knowledge. Try to internalize knowledge and think about how we can use that knowledge to improve our lives, career, work, relationships, etc. Whenever we encounter a thought, think yourself, is this thought worth it? And then decide accordingly. Now the question arises here is, how do we decide? So only one thing is, don't make any quick decisions. Whenever the things are in future, we suddenly say yes. We and our all colleagues and friends say, yaar, abhi May aane wala hai, let's all go to Leh and Ladakh. But we'll be like, yeah, definitely, I'm all in. Instead, start saying, I shall think and let you know tomorrow or give me some time to think. Be yourself, not what you should be. Conquer yourself rather than the world. Why is self-knowledge important? To know the self-worth and start acting on that. Do not try to think way out of everything. You have the ability to decide when you want to let go of your thoughts. Some take yoga as a medium, some meditate. So medium doesn't matter. You don't need anything to relax but yourself. Let go of everything. You can escape your outside world and go inside your mind to find peace. Be conventional. It's not this or that in life. You can have this and that. Like job chodo and then like start, become a wanderlust. You can. Who said that? You can do job and then start working. You can do job and also travel the world on weekends. So and don't leave with regrets. Important part here is you don't regret what you did in life. You regret what you didn't do. So yes, look back, but don't stare for too long and start regretting. Life happens now. Stop thinking and start feeling. We can never hope for absolute proof of anything. All our decisions are bets on what the universe is today and what it will be tomorrow. Greatest use of life is to spend it on something that will outlast it. If we live our lives every day with that idea in mind, that we should strive for doing, creating useful things that matter to others, we end up spending our time on things that actually make a difference. When you do that, life automatically has meaning to everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Surbhi. It was awesome, quick and crisp.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Good. I'll just speak. I think lots of thought-related topics are covered. I'll just give the direction to everyone.
Stop thinking, start feeling. I like that.
Stop thinking.
Start feeling.
Start feeling. That's awesome. Good. So, am I audible to everyone?
Yeah, you are audible.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Great. Awesome. So, there is a quote, which I learned last week. It really touched my heart. So, you can change without growing, but, you cannot grow without changing. You can change without growing, but you cannot grow without So many thoughts, after I learned this, quote, so many things, triggered into my mind. But anyway, this is Kiran here. I know I'm alumni of IIT Kharagpur. I work with a technical digital healthcare startup and I'm in Bangalore right now. So today I'll be talking about a few of the things which is quite important for all of us. So where we all have, goals, we all have, thoughts going on in our mind. We all have our daily life and which we are all, struggled. We are all fussed in our life. थॉट्स ये सब चीज तभी काम आएगा जब लाइफ में कुछ गोल हो राइट लाइफ में कुछ जज्बा हो लाइफ में कुछ तहलका मचाने वाली फीलिंग हो राइट एंड दैट इज ऑलवेज क्लोज टू माई हार्ट टूडे स्पीक अबाउट फ्यू पॉइंटर्स आपको मैं तीन से चार पॉइंट्स बताऊंगा जो आपको अपने गोल्स को सेट करने के लिए यूज आएगा एंड ट्रस्ट मी इट्स नॉट दैट आई एम टेकिंग फ्रॉम माई ओन एक्सपीरियंस बट देयर इज अ वंडरफुल बुक गोल्स बाय ब्रायन ट्रेसी व्हिच आई कवर्ड लास्ट वीक एज वेल So I'll be just touching few points what Brian Tracy also suggests कि क्या क्या points आप take care कर सकते हो जिससे आप अपनी goal को set कर पाओगे So first point he tells your goals has to be concrete
So your goals has to be concrete. आपके गोल को बहुत कॉन्क्रीट होना चाहिए. इट हैज टू बी स्पेसिफिक एंड डिटेल्ड एंड यू हैव टू बी राइट, यू हैव टू राइट इट डाउन. एंड ट्रस्ट मी फ्रेंड्स, ये ऐसा नहीं कि आपको पता नहीं होगा. अगर आप ऑफिस में काम करते हो, इफ यू हैव सीन योर चिल्ड्रन, यू नो प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एग्जाम, एवरीथिंग एवरीथिंग इज अ स्ट्रक्चर्ड गेम प्लान. अगर ऑफिस में आप देख रहे हो कंपनी ग्रो कर रही है, क्यों कर रही है? मोस्ट ऑफ अस इफ यू आर इन टेक्निकल बैकग्राउंड, वी आर नॉट प्रॉब्ली अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट हाउ द कंपनीज गोल्स आर सेट. बट एक्चुअली इफ यू गो इन डिटेल, ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट एंड एक्सप्लोर कैसे कैसे गोल सेट होता है. Every goal and every successful goal जब decide होता है, they are specifically written down with proper detailed analysis. Imagine करो, you know, if I want to, you know, let's say I want to become a cricket player. Now, if I want to become a cricket player, what exactly should I do? Under 16 मुझे fight करना है, I have to, you know, fight for under 16. Now, to fight for under 16, when should I fight? When is my price? Everything has to be taken care. Your goal has to be detailed, completely detailed, right? So this is one of the very important points. Other is, you know, it has to be time-bounded. Goal mein kick nahi aayega, maza nahi aayega, time-bound nahi ho gaya. Imagine if you go to a football field or log, you know, aap ball ko le dal diye and people are playing with football, but then you see, you know, there is no goal, right? People are running here and there and, you know, log khelte ja rahe and there is no interval, there is no time-bounded, you know, period. Any sports, it's time-bounded. Because when you keep your goals time-bounded, if your goals are close to your heart, it brings best out of you. You will bring best out of yourself because your adrenaline, everything comes out of it. So this is a very important part. Ek ho gaya, aapka goal has to be specific, goal has to be detailed, goal has to be detailed down, and also it has to be time-bounded. The next, which is, you know, my favorite, goal has to be challenging. I'll tell you a very, very good story in my college time. So I used to play cricket. तो हमारे, यू नो, वी यूज्ड टू हैव प्रॉपर, बहुत ही फाड़ू टीम होती थी. वी यूज्ड टू फील कि अगर हमारी टीम साथ में मिल गई तो इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे किसी को भी हरा सकते हैं. ऐसी फीलिंग आती थी. कूल, आई थिंक नाउ आई एम ऑडिबल बेटर. Great. So in my college days, so while I was playing cricket, so there was a last, you know, match of my college. So it was finals, and you know, we were playing with IIT Guwahati, and also we were playing with other teams. Us din kuch aisa chamatkar maine dekha mere life mein, you won't believe it what happened. So we had a goal to, you know, hit 119 runs, not big runs, but dikkat ye ki we were a little bit overconfident, laga ki 119 to maar denge, you know, we'll just score it out. And I was number two, number three batsman. There's another friend called Akshat and another friend called Ankur. So we were supposed to be like triads, right? The whole team batting, you know, batting used to be to come out of this three people. So we were confident, we started good, but then dhire dhire karke main bhi out ho gaya, mera dost bhi out ho gaya, sab log aise tak karke out hone lag gaye. And luckily Akshat jo hamara dost tha wo bach gaya tha. And he was playing. He was ऐसा खेल रहा था, लग रहा था कि at least match थोड़ा last तक चले जाए, at least गंदी तरह से हारे ना. You know, college में होता है ना, थोड़ा सा ego रहता है, तो नाक कटे तो बच जाएगा, लगेगा कि fight मार के हारे हैं या फिर जीते हैं. ऐसे करते करते, you know, it was, you know, 20 overs match. We scored 19th or 20th over में. 19th over में, they were, you know, we have to score around 20 runs, 25 runs. And Akshat didn't have any, you know, batsman to follow. He was only batsman who was, you know, hitting up. And in the 19th over, when we had to score 25 runs, something amazing happened. So we were superbly passionate about, you know, cricket, and we had this goal ki hume jitna hi jitna hai is match ko. And us din Akshat ke andar koi bolte na jaise mata aa jati hai, some, you know, ghost comes. That day I felt ki uske andar really bhi koi international level ka jo cricket khelta hai na, uska koi aake, you know, bhoot chadh gaya uske andar. He was hitting sixer and four aise, you know, just so smoothly he was hitting. And we were almost close. We hit around 15-16 runs in second last over. Last over was humko 8-7 runs chahiye tha. And that over, you know, we fought, and we scored only, I think, 5-6 runs. We lost by only one run. We lost by one run, but that match I couldn't ever forget because we worked so hard, passionately, because we had that goal in our mind ki 4 saal humne mehnat ki to kuch to ukhaar ke jana hi hai. And that gave us tremendous kick and brought us the best in, you know, best from ourselves. So what I'd like to say is it has to be challenging. Agar goal challenging bhi nahi hai to aap kitna bhi, you know, kar lo, aapko wo andar se feeling nahi aayegi, achhi wali feeling nahi aayegi, right? And the last thing is, you know, which always, you know, comes into the character. Whatever goals you keep, it has to come, you know, it has to, you know, sync with your character and sync with your goals. For an example, to give an example, agar mujhe, you know, let's say mera business karna, I'm doing my job and I have crunch in my life of time. I have to spend time with my girlfriend. I have to spend time with my job properly. I have to spend time with business. Now, sab kuch main karna chahta hu ki main cricket bhi khelunga. Sab challenge ho jayega. Now, I have to decide. I have to prioritize ki us time pe kaun mere liye important hai. Agar main job na karke cricket khelne lag jaunga, to meri job haath mein chali jayegi. And if job haath mein chali gayi, then you know you can't do anything else, right? Most of us depend job for our survival. So, goal has to be congruent. It cannot be, you know, out of the parallel road mein ulta the, you know, disha mein nahi jana chahiye. So there are a few 4 to 5 points. I'll just summarize. So first we discussed this goal has to be specific, measurable, and it has to be detailed. And best part, if you can write it down your goal, that is the best. And the second is goal has to be time-bounded. And the third has to be goal has to be challenging. And the fourth has to be goal has to be congruent with the values and the game plan which you set. These are the four important points which I really learned from, you know, the book Goals. The fundamental, you know, pillar of all these learnings is why. You know, you have to determine why you want that goal. Most people, and honestly, I'm telling you, most people will have doubt. Sabko aisa lagta hai ki mera goal hai VP banna. Let's say my goal is to become a CEO. Mera goal hai mujhe, you know, bada sa businessman banna hai. Sab log position level mein goal rakhte hain. That is where the challenge is. Rather than thinking about a position-based goal, think about an outcome. While we were playing cricket as well, we were not, you know, excited ki hame, you know, top team banna hai. Our goal was to get that feeling. Yeah, jab jeetenge na, you know, wo jo feeling hai na, you can't express. Your tears will just flow from your eyes. You will see that respect people will be giving you, and you know, your parents or everyone will start clapping you. Just imagine, you know, you're getting that kind of output. And let's say you want to do business, let's say you want to become a VP. Why do you want to become a VP? Soch ke dekho, agar mujhe vice president banna hai company ka, kyun banna hai mujhe? Think about it. And then write it down. Because agar aapke paas reasons nahi honge na, to aap us journey mein quit kar jaoge. And you need to have at least 10 to 15 reasons minimum. Kyunki agar if I ask anyone ki why do you want to, you know, let's say aapko kyun banna hai artist. Trust me, honestly, logo ke paas jyada reason hote nahi. Maximum I've heard, logo ke paas 2 to 3 reason hote hai, wo bhi abstract. Nobody has a real, you know, proper reason to really follow. But the challenge is if you have more reasons, 30, 40 reasons, haan mujhe speaker banna, I want to impact people. You know, when I speak, my parents should sit in front of, you know, the chair, and they should watch me. They should get proud. I should start impacting society by helping poor people. I have to go to, you know, sir, maybe I have to go to some social service, feed them. You need to have 30, 40 minimum reasons to really, really get pumped in your life. So this is an overall summary of goals, friends. So I'm sure you will, you know, start reading this book called Goals. It is a super book. And definitely, if you have any doubts, do reach out to us. And the best part is, you know, it is not who, you know, abhi jo jaise main baat kar raha hu, I was not like that before. It was only because of the mentor and the coaching which I received from Vijay, because Vijay himself created this, you know, system for all of us to grow. And if you are new, you don't know, there's a system called Peak Impact Mentorship. Iske karan Vijay ne launch kiya, and Vijay is super passionate about teaching and personal growth. And because of his mentorship, for past almost 3 to 4 years, I've been in touch with him. I'm accountable to him. And recently also Madhvi also joined with me. So we all are accountable to Vijay and his vision. And we are very passionate about growth. That is the reason we are doing all this book club. So if you have any doubts, do reach out to us. And, you know, we'll move to the next speaker next. Thank you so much. We'll move to the next speaker.
Thank you.
Great. So Dilip Chachu, I think you can speak. We have very interesting story from Chachu.
Hello everyone. Good evening. And I'm Dilip Gupta. I'm from Odisha. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. I'm Dilip Gupta from Odisha, joining from Pune. I'm part of Peak Impact Mentorship since last 1 year. Okay. So I got so many learnings from this Peak Impact Mentorship. So I just like this association. Okay. So today's topic, like I wanted to share you some life story of an author, and the author name is J.K. Rowling. By the name you may not be knowing. Some people may not be knowing. If I say the movie name, then everyone will everyone can connect. So the movie name is, you know, Harry Potter. Harry Potter has so many series and some movies. Okay. So the Harry Potter story and the book author name is J.K. Rowling. She's a lady and she's a British writer. Now her age will be about 55 years. And she's also a screenwriter and best known for his all 7 Harry Potter children book series. Okay. So I'll talk about her today. First, I'll say share some success stories from her. Now, by now, like nearly 450 million copies was sold for all those series of books. And in 2004, Rowling became the first person to become a US dollar billionaire by writing only books. And the second richest female entertainer. And in 2013, 13 most powerful women in UK. She has become. And also right in 2017, her estimated income was like around 650 million pound. Okay, as per the Sunday Times. And mostly highly paid author on the day now. So, but this is her success story. But we all may not know that what kind of issue, what would have been his her struggle period, how he has got this success. So I'll put some light upon the childhood. When she was 4 year old, she was living with her family in a village, and during his childhood itself. She was a passionate writer. You know, in our childhood, what we used to do when we create our stories and we used to tell our younger brothers and sisters. But she was writing the story and she was telling her stories to her sister that time. And in that time itself, her great aunt gave her one book called Jessica Mitford. She's the writer, she's autobiography. And she's become the heroine of her life, the role model of her life. So what happened, you know, she has some problem with the, she was quite unhappy during his teenage years. Okay, so her mother had got, she was suffering, her mother was suffering from a multiple sclerosis and she has a bad relationship, like unhealthy relationship with her father. She was not talking to her, the relationship with her mother and father was not good. So all this happened and after that, but she was a bright student and she was very good at in English. Okay. And but later what happened when she started writing the book Harry Potter, she was working in a bilingual secretary in London. Also she started working she worked the Chamber of Commerce. And what happened when she was in a delay train, she conceived the idea of writing the book Harry Potter. Okay. And what happened then, her marriage life was not good. She was a divorcee and she moved to Portugal and then she started staying along with her sister. And again, like she had a miscarriage also during her married life, and she that couple got separated, and she got domestic abuse also, and during that time she got a baby as well. She's so alone. She was a single mother and started raising her child.
And also during that time, she started writing the book. And while she was writing the book, she lost her mother also. And again, in poverty, she went into depression. And also what happened, she was finally about to suicide. She was thinking of a suicide. Finally, after a very much struggle, with a very, I'm just about to complete.
Sure.
Yeah. So with a much of struggle, she completed the book, Harry Potter. The first copy, and also what happened, the 12 publishing houses, they rejected the book. But finally, she got a deal of £8,000 to start with, and that gave her energy to continue writing the books. So from there, she got the success in writing the book, and the book got so much publicity, and the turning point was when the book was sold in Scholastic for $1,05,000. That was the turning point. So the main idea about telling about her story is like, she never gave up. She never gave up the struggling. She had a mind to write a book after getting all kind of failures from family, from his husband, from his from all sides, as I mean to say. So finally, she got success. And the thing we need to learn here is we should never give up when we want to do something. Thank you for listening to me.
Awesome, Chachu. It was great learning. Never give up. Great. So due to shortage of time, we'll just take a couple of more speakers. So in case, we missed out with anyone, really, sorry for that. We just want to keep it time bound so that, we can really wind up properly and we can add value to everyone. Great. So next, last online speaker will take Sahana. Are you there?
Hi, Kiran. Am I audible?
Yeah, Sahana, you're audible. Go ahead, yeah.
Hi, guys. I'm Sahana. I work for Northern Trust as a man by Madhavi. My topic for today is a law of environment. So we all know we need a good, great environment to grow. So growing on the ladder of success, it could be with people, it could be with wealth, it could be with anything that we really want to achieve, we need a great environment. So an encouraging environment is very important for us. So the first thing, in fact, the book club also is a part of a growing environment, I guess. All of them who are here would definitely agree, because this is a great vibration that we all get to learn more. To have a good environment, especially in the current days when we all know, we all go to office, it's a lot of negative sometimes. So the first thing is we need a change. Change is the only constant thing. And without changing, we cannot grow. So that's one thing that we all heard, with that it's constant and it has to be done. So the major impacted one is environment for, to have a betterment in our lives. Environment is the greatest change we need to work on. And to grow in this world, it's not just the environment, it's also the self that needs to be improved. So it goes hand in hand when both ourselves and the environment is a changing environment and a growing environment. The growth gets faster and also seems less difficult. So even if we are growing self and we don't have a growing environment, we would still not grow that fast, or it wouldn't be that easy. So if it's going hand in hand, it's all the more easier. Also, it would include who we spend our time with. So the environment would include our friends, our family, our thoughts, our anything that we really want to put thought, our mind into and work on. So all of these would include the growing environment. Like Swami Vivekananda has told, show me your friends and I'll tell you where you're going to be in the future. So I'm sure that, you know, with this kind of, you know, crowd where we are being more, we're being more pushed to do something better than what the rest of the crowd. 95% of the crowd wouldn't see this. The 5% of the crowd, like the members in the book club would agree, would want to see a change. And each thing that we handle on a daily basis would impact with the environment that we have. So in a growing environment, we all need... we need to do a self-challenge, because it's easy to just go hand in hand with, I mean, and just go along with people who are, not really successful, because it's easy to live that life. But to have a successful life, we need to be more hardworking. And that environment is really, challenging. And these challenges can be taken up inspiringly when you decide a goal that not everybody does, and also the a deadline that you give to your goal is also matters. And you can actually find some mentors like this whom we can all be able to relate to. I think Peak Impact Mentorship would definitely help find a mentor where we can, you know, relate to their strength, what they're currently learning, so we can also be there sometime in future. So right now, what we have to do is just focus on the moment, have a vision to reach a goal. So I would just want to end with one last saying. So to reach our goals, potentials, we must not only do what others believe you can't, but also what we believe we can't. So it's challenging ourselves. And this belief is possible and doable with this mentorship program that Vijay has found for all of us. And I guess we all have the potential to build such a culture and environment to grow and have a great environment. I think that's it from my side.
Superb, superb. It's awesome, Sahana. Great summary. That's awesome. Great. So we'll move to our last, offline speakers here. So we have, we call someone as Iron Man in our team, So Bhushan is one of a very good friend. So we call Bhushan as Iron Man. I'm a big fan of superhero. So, Avengers, so Iron Man is on stage.
Am I coming? I'm audible. Okay. So hello everyone. My topic also from the Rich Dad and Poor Dad, which Dheeraj has covered already. But I like some point from this book. So I will conclude 4 to 5 point. So what I like is Robert Kiyosaki is the businessman, and he come from the middle family like us, most of us. And he is a businessman, he's an author, and is financially free. So whatever he written, it's not a theory, it's a practical, first of all. So I like 4 to 5 point, what he observed. So he had two father. One is a rich dad, one is a poor dad. Poor dad is his own dad. He had the excellent degree, PhD, and 2-3 degree actually. And that his rich dad, hardly eighth pass only, but that rich father was a billionaire, and the poor one is struggling for the money. So what he observed actually, तो उन्होंने क्या बोला रॉबर्ट कियोसाकी ने, what he observed 4 to 5 key point, he thought कि that जो rich लोग होते हैं, right, they thought the money is the root of the so lack of the money is the root of the evil. Okay, and the poor people think the love of the money is the root of the evil. It means what? Jiske paas paisa nahi hota, jo middle class families hota hai, right? I am also come from middle family, and most of people what talk, right? Ki paisa jyada karke kya karenge? But think, jo Dhirubhai Ambani, are anyone jo rich hain, and ask to them, they love the money, because they have money, they help the people, they do the charity. Okay, so they understand, but what is the thought process is like जो गरीब आदमी होता है, पुअर आदमी होता है, वो कमाना नहीं चाहता, उसके पास पैसे नहीं होते, इसलिए वैसा बोलता है। लेकिन जो रिच मैन है उसको पता है कि कैसे पैसे कमा सकते हैं, राइट। सेकेंड थिंग व्हाट ही टोल्ड इज लाइक कि मोस्ट ऑफ हम लोग जो मिडिल क्लास फैमिली से आते हैं, राइट, तो हमें जो कॉलेजेस में, स्कूल्स में प्रोफेशनल स्किल के बारे में बहुत अच्छे तरह से पढ़ाया जाता है, बट फाइनेंशियल फ्रीडम के, फाइनेंशियल जो स्किल्स होता है वो हमें पढ़ाया जाता है हमारे पेरेंट्स के थ्रू, विच दे आर ऑल्सो कम फ्रॉम द मिडिल क्लास फैमिली। तो जो एक ब्रोक पर्सन है, जो पुअर है, वो कैसे पढ़ाएगा कि वो कैसे पैसे कमा सकते हैं? दैट इज द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जो हम लोग इग्नोर करते हैं। हम लोग का फोकस होता है कि यार डॉक्टर बनेंगे, पीएचडी करेंगे, बट व्हाई वी डू, जैसे किरण बोल रहे थे कि क्यों हम पीएचडी करना चाहते हैं, पैसा कमाने के लिए, अल्टीमेटली स्टेटस के लिए, रिस्पेक्ट के लिए, लाइक सो अंबानी इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग रिस्पेक्ट, ही डिडंट डू द पीएचडी एंड ऑल थिंग, आई थिंक सो। So, okay, so time is already done. So this is the very, very important thought he observed. Okay, so I could not cover all the point, but this is the what two, three points I learned. So I will speak about in the next week some other interesting point. Thank you.
Hi all, this is Karthik here. I am into software. So before I finish, I want to tell about a short story. This is by the person called Robert Schuller, and this story happened in 1982 in America. Okay, so in that year it was a Great Depression in America. How recession happened in 2001 and 2008, right? It was something like that. There was a lot of unemployment and recession there also. You know how political government will be during that time. They just blame the economy or something, and Republicans, Democrats, they all blame each other. So it's like all the blame game which happens, but nobody finds a solution for it. And Robert Schuller, as I told you, he to tell about himself, like he's a pastor of Crystal Cathedral and head of National Television Ministry. Okay, and he has around 500 people in his payroll. And he was running a $20 million revenue a year. Okay, so this was about Robert Schuller. And during this time, during this depression time, he was supposed to give a motivational lecture, and it was not new to him because he was into it. And the motivational lecture consisted of around 3,500 plus people from agriculture background, mainly farmers, and these people were about to lose their lands and businesses because of the depression. What Robert Schuller with what mindset he went was like to give a motivational lecture with crack some jokes and all that. But after listening to these guys, seeing these guys, why they have come, they needed hope. He was like thinking what to speak. Okay, so how did he speak and how did he give hope to them? Probably I'll cover next week and about the book as well. Yeah, thank you. Good night.
Is this fine now? I don't know. How is this? See, I'm the IT perfectionist, I already told you guys. Is it working? Is it fine now? Okay. So I am Madhvi. I work for a pharmaceutical company. Most of you already know me, but those who don't know me, I am Madhvi. And it was so great to see all of you. Thank you so much for joining. And clock is running, but I will just take a very short minute of your time to summarize what we have learned so far. I am so excited that my blood is running from my head to toe. I am that excited. So I was supposed to cover a book, but then I thought before that I will just cover all the learnings that I have been having in these very few book reading club that we have had. So rich gets richer, poor gets poorer, because rich has a bigger picture to see. So you also should see the bigger picture, and you should think of how to become rich. The reason is that when you think of any investment or when you think about what is the right investment and what is not a right investment, that is when your knowledge of asset and liability is very important. And that is why we should learn and apply the knowledge we read from Rich Dad and Poor Dad. So once you know that, then what will happen is you'll start thinking, what do you want from life? And because you will have clear picture of what is the asset, what is the liability, what is the correct investment, and how richer are becoming richer. So when you think about those big, that is when you are applying your thinking of magic of thinking big. After that, when you apply magic of thinking big, what you should think and grow rich. So when you think, you think bigger things. How will I become rich? You do not have to think about how will I do it. Just you focus on what do you want. The reason is you think what do you want, then automatically power of your subconscious mind will work, and that will be your dominant thought process. That will be attracting these things. Now, when power of subconscious thinking works on you, we are also applying our knowledge that we are reading from the book, What to Say When You Talk to Yourself, because it talks about how you program your thinking process. Once you have that, then you are clear, you have big thinking, you have you know what you want from life, you know how to program your mind, you know how you are going to attract these big things. That is when you set a goal for yourself. Now, how the goal should be, that Kiran summarized very well. It should be challenging, it should be concurrent, it should be bounded, it should be I missed one point. What was that? Can you help me? It should be prioritized with your character on how do you want to prioritize in the hierarchy of what do you want. So that you achieve the real success. What is real success that I just read today? Is R for relationship, E for equipped, A for attitude, L for leadership, because your attitude is everything. Now, after you have the goal, so I will just talk about this story. I listened to a lot of this motivational speaker, and this is a book that I was read. This is a CD that I was listening. When I travel from my home to my office, it's a very long journey. So I try to, you know, invest that time in some kind of learning. And I listened to these motivational CDs. So when I was listening to the CD, now enjoy this, okay? This is very important. So just think, if you play basketball, your ball is all your energy, all the attitude, everything that you're putting to yourself. And then that net that you see, that is where, that is your goal. So you're putting your energy to the goal. Now you have thought so much, you know what you want from life, you know what is a real asset, you know everything now. You have put all your energy. You are all ready, you're playing basketball, you have all that goal, right, with your energy. Now you have to put in a net. Now imagine there is no net. You are all with your energy, you jumped, you tried, you have the ball, but there is no net. Where do you throw it? That will happen if you don't have the goal. So having a good goal is very, very important. Now, once you have the goal, how you have the goal, you have all this thinking process, that is when your law of environment will also work with you. Like Sahana covered, how with these dreamers you will be, and you will also think big, and you will attract big, you'll have positive attitude around you. So that is how you will succeed. Now, from the time you learn what is asset, what is liability, and sort all these cookies from your mind, and then till the time you achieve success, it is a big journey. In that big journey, many times you will fail, but failure, from that also you can capitalize towards your success. How to do that? I'm reading this book, Failing Forward, which I'll share next week. Thank you so much. And if you have any question and you want to know more about how do you create even a stronger law of environment, connect with the person who invited you. Thank you so much and good night, everyone.
Awesome, awesome, great. Thank you, Madhvi, for this wonderful summary. So friends, if you all are fine, we can keep it for next 5 minutes for Q&A session in case anyone has any question. So in case anyone doesn't have any question, we can wind it up. Cool, I think. Just
a second. Either we are so hungry or we are crystal clear.
I guess all are filled with full with learnings, and I'm sure, you know, we'll start applying this coming week and we'll share more learnings in next week. So friends, get back to the person who's invited you and be in touch. We all are, me, Madhvi, everyone who is a volunteer over here is accountable to Vijay. So if anyone needs any help, do connect us and keep growing. Good night. Thank you so much.
Bye. Good night.
Bye. Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.